Welcome back, Ryan. Costin here on Serious Gaming, continuing my walkthrough of the Banner Saga on the hard difficulty. So I have gained a number of troops. I have gained Luden, Irsa, which is a competent archer, actually. And her ability is, well, let's just say, pretty fucking powerful. Very powerful, in fact, if used correctly. So, actually, going to heroes, I'm curious about Eric Rowley. Okay, of city warfare, alright. So he's a warden of the city. Is that it, though? Eric is the guy who gets stuff done for the governor of Strand. Though tough for a man with a heavy responsibility, he seems to have an awful lot of freedom in his methods. Iron Turtle. Luden is the Prince of Man, the next in line to become the High King of, to become King of most of the continent. He's not well liked among either peers or rivals, mostly due to his high born attitude. However, not many will claim that he isn't smart, a well trained fighter, or lacking courage. He currently finds himself, somewhat against his will, on a visit to the Varl capital. In what his father hopes becomes a new era of rule by his lineage. Right, Irsa. Not many people know much about where Irsa came from, but ever since Luden became old enough to train, Irsa has been close by. Rumors used to spread about romantic relations between the two until Irsa found out about them and then suddenly stopped. Those who have spent much time near her have described the woman as intimidating. Yeah, no shit. It's something of a legend in Varl culture. When he met Fangnir, it was during the Second Great War, in which the two became known for cutting a swath through Dredge where others were struggling just to stay alive. Fangnir was always the charismatic leader, but there was no question about which of the two would win in a fight. Alright, Morg. Morg's an old hand in Varl culture, long on the front line of fight against Dredge. He's had the occasional brush with leading a clan of his own, but eventually settled well into commanding Wagner's personal army of Varl warriors, and is highly respected among them. Alright, Gunnulf. When Obi became the Varl king's tax collector, he was given an entourage of bodyguards to help transport gold collected across Bronn. Gunnulf is the only one from the original group still alive, and for good reason. Yeah, no shit. Right, so that's it, and then there's Percy. Even Luden seems afraid of him, which may be the primary reason he hasn't been sent away. On the rare occasion, it has been whispered that the Earl doesn't even work for the Prince, but some other group altogether. What is well known is that he's already saved Luden's life on more than one occasion. Alright, so, gain those three, and I'm gonna leave right now. And we're gonna have a battle. Challenge the world over your conversation and marching alongside the warriors. I'm happy to stamp some flags as much as the next world, but I didn't join up to take over this for half months as well. Apparently, this will explore within the other shop and I'm going to die for reminders. Okay. Challenge the world. Fight. Will you take orders from me? Ask Bobby. Wagner's dead, and you can disagree right now. Raise your fists, he does the same with Lucky. His best shot is not bad, but he can't block this. Grab him by the bones, so he can grab my screen from here. What's his name? He asks us. It's Gris. Take care of Gris for the love. You heard them laughing at his misfortune as you wander off. Deal with the bridge. Make a part. Selling supplies of food. this has been a DMX blessing in some ways. Because it's gonna bite you in the ass eventually. But I guess it's the only way to be able to get that there ring. If we plotted it to them, but we saw them first. Great watcher when waiting to sort you. And it's the last time you can end with your commands. Don't overthink it, the world can take this for themselves. Alright. Yes, yes. Bridge on the battlefield. Strong, the fight seems to be. Take a quick head count. There seems to be at least 66 of them. They have to be for the fighters and 66 Marl. This looks like bitch against desert. Charge! Rush into the battle. Allies, right. So, I'm not gonna take Gunwolf because it's a pointless idea to get him involved in this. Considering that I can already level him up. So I'm gonna take all of these guys. And it's gonna be, well, I'm gonna try and win both battles. You have the first battle and you win the war, as it were, but you can have a second one to be able to do more damage to the enemy. Fucked up here. This is not going to be a pleasant situation, is it? If you then what you can get is a very useful item. That fire will stay in complete damage. Like, it's, I just did what, 6 HP damage, and she's just level 1. What's level 1? Quite a bit. She's gonna become Sledgehammer. You can get very few, and then you can count yourself very fucking lucky, or you can get a great deal of them, and then be screwed completely. But minimal casualties. And a lot of troops killed. It's gonna be quite... well, I did lose quite a bit in that respect. So, siege archer. Well, ability, which is the best thing about her, but I can't actually need a certain amount to be able to do that. So for a moment, more days for these guys. I'll rest. That should be enough. It's the food you got from the merchants. That's why. One rush back just across the breath. Dredge that direction. Tell a little bit about the way he found the village. You could ask him about they're tearing the place apart since maybe thousands of people got in the lost. This will be a bigger fight than usual. Draw some of them forward and split them. We send a small group of shield bangers to get their attention. And maybe half a day later, many dredge are given chills up the hill in their plodding sort of way. We get ready to be faced. Alright. Charge. We have the advantage. Use it very well and do a truckload of damage. Once I'm able to level up Gunnulf, I'm going to do that. And then... Oh! This is a wonderful situation. Look at this. Oh, I already fought this kind of battle before. So... But if I do move right there... If I move her here, she's likely going to be hit. And obviously at this point in time, I do not wish this to happen. So... right here, and throw wow, and actually that screwed me over big time. Yeah, I wasn't thinking properly. I was like, oh yeah, let's do this. Nope, not a good idea at all. It's a good idea to do this, by the way, because you'll have to fight this dredge anyway, so like this is a wise move indeed. So Percy before Ursa. Archers, well, archers are opponents for the prong. Very them hit you. I know. Ah, right. Oh shit, I'm in a bad position, am I not?
him.
Yeah, I am. Well, if I don't take him down a notch, then I'm gonna suffer. Oh, there you go. There she goes down. At least she leveled up. That's all I can say, really. I did suffer because my willpower was lower. Yeah, I probably waited too much there. Right, now she is definitely gonna get to the level up. Oh wait, the ability levels up automatically. So what do I do with her? Well, obviously I could level up her armor penetration. I'm gonna do that and also spend a point in willpower. Then level up Luden, because Luden is very useful. As much as he is a prick, and he definitely is one, he is also a very useful fighter. Anyway, that's that. Costin here on Serious Gaming, signing out. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Thank you all for watching and stay tuned for more. Also, if you'd like to help the channel, there's a donation link in the description below. Also, don't forget to check out my videos on the donation as well.